Om Mahaganapataye Namaha. In this video, I'm going to talk about karma and three ways you can remove it to fast track a new destiny. Now, very briefly, if you haven't seen Dr. Pillai's teachings about karma, I will put a link in the description of this video where you can find out more. But in summary, or in short, karma is the dictating force which is controlling your life. Whatever you want to experience, whatever you want to create new, you have to build the karma for it. And as we've looked at in past videos, we have a few modern definitions of karma. One from Dr. Pillai says, karma is your mindset. And we have quantum physics or particle physics saying it's the observer. The observed and the observer are one and the same. We've also looked at the concepts of the information that you hold within your subconscious and unconscious and even in your biology, which is projected out around you as the external reality, which is the effect of the cause, which is the karma. The information is also karma. So karma is your identity, it's your personality, it's your mindset, it's the way you think, it's the way that you act, it's the way that you feel. It's your biology, it's your neurology, and it's your psychology. All those things that you have crystallized to experience and express as your individual self, most of which is being done on a subconscious and unconscious level, which is why it can seem there can be a contradiction between what you're consciously wanting and what's actually happening, because most of the mind is veiled beneath the conscious mind. So karma is very, very important, and I will share one of the reasons I'm making this video is because my life has been changing at a rapid, rapid pace. I've been saying it, comparing it to like it's been a tornado of change. And in general, this is all because of my karma is changing. And it's important to focus on your karma. We've done a lot of videos in the past about mindset and manifestation and all this, which is all about changing your karma. But in this video particularly, I want to share a few different ways that are techniques and technologies that specialize in removing karma. So in general, there are some power times around karma, which I'm going to talk about, and then also some technologies as well. Now, power times are celestial alignments. See, the way that time rolls out, the natural intelligence of the universe, this is the whole concept of astrology, is that there are certain times that are conducive to performing certain things when nature supports it. And when nature supports it, it's much more likely to happen and bear fruit, as opposed to if you're doing things against the grain or against the natural intelligence that is available, it's likely not to succeed. So as Dr. Pillai talks about, the Siddhas don't do anything. They always wait. They don't do anything unless it's the right time, because they basically have managed to merge themselves with time or stay in tune with time, so that they are operating on sort of an autopilot, where it gets to the point where you don't have to try to use time, just naturally you do that. And that's by becoming in tune with time, actually mastering time itself. So time is very, very important. And particularly there is two times that I'll talk about now. That is the 13th moon, which happens twice a month. There's a 13th waning moon and a 13th waxing moon. And there is a time, depending on the sources, I go by the source of Augustier. He says 1.5 hours up into and 30 minutes after sunset. And both of these times are known as Pradosham. Now, the mythology behind Pradosham is when the gods and demons were churning the ocean, the cosmic ocean, to attain the elixir of immortality. Prior to this result, they had a problem where the snake they were using, Vasuki, so they had the demons on one side, the gods on the other side, and they had a mountain in the middle. And underneath the mountain was a giant tortoise named Kurma. And this mountain was spinning on top of the tortoise. So the gods would pull, or the demons would pull one way, or the gods, demons, and they were churning the ocean like this. And as a result of this, this was a snake they were using as a churning rope. And what happened was, there are other secrets to this. You can go look at augustier.org. Maybe I'll put a link in the description of this video where you can read more about this. Vasuki was his name. He's a snake that you can see around Shiva's neck. That's Shiva's snake. Vomited poison. And this poison represented represents the poison of the world, the collective universal karma. And it was wreaking havoc, and Shiva had to come and swallow this poison in order to save the world. And he did this, and before he could swallow it and get down to his stomach, his consort Parvati came and stopped it at his throat, and his throat turned blue. And so he is known as Nilakantam, which means Nila means blue, and Kantam means throat. So Nilakantam, when you say the mantra from Dr. Pillai, Tiru Nilakantam, Tiru means holy. It's a Tamil word. It's kind of like Shri. It's a holy, auspicious word. It's used to when you're saying the names of gods and just in general when you want to put a divine expression onto it. So Tiru Nilakantam is literally invoking that mythological event, which, remember, mythologies, as we talked about in the past videos that Dr. Pillai teaches, are not arbitrary stories. Mythologies are both real on the external, and they're also a language of the soul. There are many, many layers and layers of symbology embedded within mythologies. And the concept of mythotherapy, even hearing this story, is it is a language of your soul, where it's sort of like the different words and the different images and the different circumstances are like zip files that when your soul hears them, it unlocks this information within. And they're therapeutic to read and hear about them because they're empowering to the soul and in general. So when you hear a story about Shiva swallowing the poison, this is a therapeutic myth for karma removal. And the why I tell that story is because it was during a Pradosham, apparently, that this cosmic event happened. And in particular, I believe, if I have my information correct, that it happened originally on Saturday. A Saturday Pradosham, are known as Shani Pradosham. So each day of the week has a unique form of karma that can be removed. Among those, Shani Pradosham is considered to be the most powerful Pradosham in terms of it is when you can remove the most severe karma. And a lot of this has to do with when Shiva originally performed this, it was done during a Shani Pradosham. And so when you say the mantra Tiru Nilakantam, you can visualize your throat being blue. You can visualize a blue light coming into the throat. And I'll get into the techniques in just a moment. So you have the 13th moons, and you have this hour and a half up until sunset, and a half an hour after, which is a twilight. Now, this time happens every single day. And this is the one in particular, both of them I've been using, but in particular, this one I observe every single day, and I definitely attribute it to my success and my ability to experience all these profound changes in a very short amount of time. So if you want to accelerate this, this is what you want to be doing, is using Pradosham time. Now, it's this time when your karma moves into a more malleable or liquid-like state, where it's more easily removed. And this is the natural intelligence available at this time. So the three techniques that I want to talk about are technologies, and there are several, definitely. One of them I talked about previously is this mantra, Tiru Nilakantam. You can also put Ma Karol Shivaya Nama. And these are, I will put a link in the description of this video where you can listen to at least one of these mantras in Dr. Pillai's voice. Tiru Nilakantam we looked at was talking about the blue-throated Shiva who removes the karma of the people. And then we have Ma Karol Shivaya Nama. What Dr. Pillai has said about this is this invokes the power of a certain power spot or temple in India. And this temple, one of the unique features of this temple is it is associated with accelerated karma removal. So when you say Ma Karol Shivaya Nama, you are accelerating the removal of karma. And Dr. Pillai has often taught them to be used together as Tiru Nilakantam Ma Karol Shivaya Nama. And what you do is you close your eyes and you put your attention on your throat, and you can also put your attention on your shoulders, and you visualize blue light coming in, or blue light in those areas, particularly in the socket of your shoulders. So different parts of your body carry karma, and the throat and the shoulders are the most primary ones. Of course, your brain, your heart as well, you can go your stomach and also your sex chakra as well. Anywhere you feel where you're holding on to karma. But these are the particular areas we're holding on a lot of karma here, where it's stored. the socket bones of the shoulders, and the Adam's apple, that particular area of the throat. You want to focus blue light into that and then associate that blue light with the sounds. Tirunilakantam Makara Shivaya Nama. Tirunilakantam Makara Shivaya Nama. And you can go on and chant this on 13th moons, and in particular during this Pradosham time that happens every single day. And now, this hour and a half and half an hour prior to and post sunset, if you do that during 13th moon, that would be considered as, if you just want to do this once in a while, that would be do not miss times. That is when you're going to have a double whammy of power, where karma removal is going to be very, 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 very easy. So do this mantra during those times. Another technology is pouring water and milk over a Shivalingam. And if you can, also use a Nandi statue. There's a lot of reasons for this. Dr. Pai is often recommended. If you can use a Nandi statue with a Shiva Lingam, that is great. So what happened was, when Shiva was drinking the poison, some of the poison did drip down apparently onto the earth plane, and Nandi, Shiva's bull, or Shiva's vahana or vehicle, went and took onto that poison, or swallowed some of that poison to clean up the rest of it. So Nandi is also very important. And also during the first Pradosham, during the Shani Pradosham, apparently you can see a darshan image. The Nandi is very involved in that, where Shiva was dancing on Nandi's head. And there's a lot of symbols and meaning to this, deeper meaning to this. But if you just have a Shivalingam, that's okay. Dr. Pai has also said, if you don't have a Shivalingam, like a proper murti, like a crystal lingam or something like this, you can also buy the stone lingams that are out of a certain river. They look like a oval. You could also take a find a smooth rock outside and take that in and consider that a Shivalingam. You just treat it like a Shivalingam, and give it the proper respects, and through that you can bring it to life. Now what you want to do is an hour and a half and a half an hour prior to and after sunset, pour water and milk, and this is a hydration technology. And now when you do this one, you want to let this milk go down the drain. You don't want to, as much as possible, try to avoid getting the milk and water on you. This milk and water is removing your karma. And so the water milk is going to be carrying that. So you want to allow it to go down the drain. If you get it on you, it's okay. Just wash your hands if you need to change your clothes or whatever. Do this at that time. It's very, very powerful. The last one I will share is using, you can use lime, lemon, pumpkin, coconut. And what you do is, during these same times as well, you will roll these around the certain areas of your body. And what is Dr. Pai said about this is a sympathetic magic, or it's a certain technology, a spiritual technology, where these items that I just shared have the properties built within them, the natural intelligence to absorb your karma. And then what you do is you sacrifice them, just like when Jesus sacrifice on the cross. This is also a technology where you have Ganapati sacrificing with his statues for his birthday. And the secret behind this is, once when Ganapati, the wisest of all the beings, approached his father Shiva, and I forget the exact story verbatim, but Dr. Pai tells this story, where Ganapati was saying that, he's observed that it's only through sacrifice that you can get changes to happen and make changes. And so he asked his father Shiva. He says, "O Lord, or Father, what is the greatest sacrifice that we can do?" And Shiva says, "That is to sacrifice me, because I'm the supreme being, basically." And Ganapati says, "How do I do that?" And so Baba always talks about, "Oh no, I got my." Shiva was like, "Oh no, I got myself in trouble." So Shiva, apparently, what happened was Shiva created the coconut. And he says, he gave it to Ganapati. He says, "You can use this, and sacrificing this is equivalent to sacrificing me." So, little secrets of coconut is, the coconut itself is Shiva. So if you notice, the coconut has three eyes, and the being of the beings, the most common associated with that is Lord Shiva. He has the two eyes, and he has the third eye, the perpendicular third eye. So the coconut is also a representation of the human head as well. And there's a lot of secrets to the coconut, the fluid inside and the shell being like the cranium and all this. It's not important. What's important is you can use that, the lime, lemon, or pumpkin. And what you do is, during these particular time of pradoshams, whether that's the 13th or the time around sunset, is you start at the top of your head and you roll the coconut or whatever it is you're using, and while chanting Tirulila Kantam Maha Karo Shivaya Nama, and you're rolling it around your head, you roll it around your each shoulder, and as you're doing this, you can imagine a dark energy, blue light, or whatever it comes to you. You can imagine your karma being pulled into the item you're using. You're going to do your throat, you can do your chest. I also like to do my stomach, and I also like to do my feet as well. And you can also do your knees. Knees would be very, very good. Dr. Pai has also said we hold a special kind of karma of the ego in our knees. So do these certain areas, and if you feel pain in any part of your body, do that, and just feel the blue, feel the karma going into it. You can also do your back as well. And then what you're going to do is, if you have a coconut, you want to smash that, and then throw that in the trash or put it in a place of nature where it's not going to be bothered. So what I like to do is, you can use grocery bags that you get from the grocery store, like those plastic bags, or you can use garbage bag. You put the coconut in there, you spin it a little bit, and then you can smash the coconut on the ground, and it all stays in the bag. Now, you want to do this a little gently, because if you do it too hard, you'll get holes in the bag and the juices will go everywhere. So just do it hard enough to smash it, and then throw it directly in the trash, especially maybe you want to tie it off. Try to avoid getting the juices on you with the lemon and the lime, and also pumpkins the same way. You want to smash it. It's a sacrifice. And the lemon and the lime as well, instead of smashing it, you can cut them. You can wear gloves, or you can cut them and wash your hands, whatever you want to do there. And especially with the limes and lemons, you can also use coconut and pumpkins. When you do it, you say, I'm cutting this lemon, or I'm cutting this lime, I'm smashing this to remove my negative karma. You can also invoke a specific karma you're working on. If you are doing this and you want to intend on removing health karma, or you can just do general. If you are focusing specific, you can invoke that or set that intention as well when you're cutting it. And again, dispose of that in the trash is the best. And if you get it on you, any of the juices, just be sure to wash your hands, change your clothes, take a shower as needed. And I'll give you one bonus one that Dr. Pai has given. This one is not just for karma, but also for miracles, is taking a veil. A veil is the spear or lance of Mudga, which represents your kundalini and third eye. And you can take a lemon or a lime. And this time you don't want to roll that. You just take that and put it on top of a veil. And you basically what you're doing is you're piercing the lemon or lime with the veil, and you can let that lemon or lime sit on the veil. You can do this once a day during Pradosham, or you can do it once in the morning, once in the evening. And Dr. Pai said every time you do this, it's about getting a miracle from Mudga. I highly recommend that as well. And it's why I recommend it, because it is so simple. It's so inexpensive. You can get those lemon or limes especially for very, very cheap. And it takes very short amount of time. I will say, once you put it on there, I like to have a little washcloth on hand that I just reuse. I have a bunch of them. And sometimes the lemon juice will leak down, which is okay, but just clean it up if you want to store it. Or you can let the juice down, however you want it. I like to do it because it's a little bit cleaner, so it doesn't let the juice get all over the altar and all that stuff. So give these a try. If you're someone who is looking to accelerate your karma removal, accelerating your manifestation, accelerating your new destiny, definitely take advantage of Pradosham and these karma removal technologies. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please leave them in the comment section underneath this video. If you like this video, make sure to click the like button and also share it with others who you think would find this information valuable too. As always, if you'd like to be notified for future videos, click subscribe and the bell notification.